raising a fool high. Some little nerves, you can go and bring the fools out. In my city, I'm respected, I ain't getting time. I heard them niggas beat your ass, I heard they set you up. Known on the block, I'm a true speaker. I only rap about my life, I don't do features. For your ass, you gotta suffer with the consequences. The one that tried to take my life was part of my defenses. I swear retaliation plans are getting kinda senseless. Father, forgive me for my sins, you know that I'm repentant. Since I lost my daddy, a nigga mind been tripping. Paranoid when I sleep, so I move different. Fuck them all, knock them down like some dominoes. Woman in that nigga, girl, pussy, that's Geronimo. I knew some niggas thuggin', I was in the field. You got a problem, we can chunk them, it's just what it is. So many motherfuckers hang out, they was happy for me. But my life is hella great and it's fantastic to me. I don't give a fuck about your thoughts and your damn interest. I run stack fucking session, that's my own business, bitch.
Podcast. I started stack sessions because I didn't want to work the regular 9-to-5, you feel me? I wanted to actually go after my dream. Even if a nigga failed, you feel me? I wanted to go after that shit. You know what I mean? I don't want to be an old ass motherfucker and just doubting myself, stressing myself out about not going to my dream, going after my dreams, you feel me? And I feel like it's a lot of people that do that. You feel me? Just try to live a regular life and impress surroundings and rather making yourself happy. So I've been through a lot of shit, man, these last couple years, and I feel like there's no other job for me to do than start my own business, put what I've been through in my movies, my music, real pain, you know, because if I didn't have this outlet, I'd probably kill a motherfucker by now to keep it real with you. All the shit I've been through. So, this is just the second chapter of my life. I'm excited for it. Shout out to my nigga Mister for recording this. The podcast you about to see is amazing. Very great artist. My cousin Maury Mack, you feel me? Real talented artist from East Oakland, California. We got a song with me, him, and Mary J. I think y'all really fucking with that since we put it on the internet. My cousin Payroll, you feel me? This is a family affair. My cousin Payroll, you feel me? Real swifty with the mic. Real swifty with the lyrics, you feel me? P.I., I mean, you can't see. C.I., you feel me? And, you feel me? Very talented. Spice One, the legend of the city, you feel me? I wanted to start, like, a certain tone with my label. We're not with the beatbox shit, you feel me? We're not doing shit like, we're not about that. We're about to rap about shit we actually going through, shit we see in our communities. You feel me? We reporters that will go down in our community. I feel like that's important in history. You feel me? That's how you came up with NWA. You feel me? That's how you came up. That's what you came up with, a lot of shit. You feel me? So, just stating what they seen in their communities or what they've been through. So, we on the same height. I'm not doing this to be famous. I'm doing this because it's a good way for me to express. It's like my counselor, you feel me? I'm not finna go sit down and talk to a white motherfucker for 2 hours and tell him everything I've been through. So, you know what I mean? I make music. I make movies. And I do my motherfucking thing, I feel like. What's some other shit? Some good ass weed I'm about to roll up right here. Let me finish this shit, though. Rob Marley performed, very talented man. Got an interview with him. Also got an interview with Maury Mack too. Two exclusive interviews that's coming just for y'all to add on with the performance. The podcast is not how it used to be. It's completely different. I just use that to basically get on. I apologize. I love everybody involved, but I feel like it's time to take it to the next level. You feel me? I wanted to get the support from my hood, and you know, and it worked out. So now it's time to get to the actual plan, get these movies out, get this music out, get these artists popping, and yeah. Welcome to the motherfucking session. Once you get complicated, you can't sit me on my path, I can concentrate. Got some shit I'm holding in, but I ain't constipated. Hey, I just wanna rap until I'm compensated. What's happening? You're here with Stack Sessions motherfucking podcast. We're bigger, better, more improved. You feel me? Bringing back having better artists. You feel me? We having better interviews. I'm changing it from what we used to be. We focusing on artists that been through shit. You feel me? We trying to put artists that been through shit and talk about real shit in their music on. It's time for a change, definitely in the Bay, my city. But yeah, so here I got my boy Rob Marley, you feel me, from Sacramento. We gonna be chopping it up, you feel me?
The boy, little gang.
Yeah, yeah, we here real comfortable chilling, you feel me, in the session, you feel me? We gonna be smoking, drinking. Got a little Remy right here, and you feel me, after, you know what I mean? We gonna take a trip around Vegas a little bit. So we gonna chop it up about my boy Rob. Tell the people where you from in Sacramento, you feel me, with certain section here, yeah, all that, you know what I mean?
Sacramento, California. Shit, I don't gangbang or nothing like that, but I'm from the east side of Sacramento.
Okay.
Yeah, man.
Okay. As far as your music, I know I just seen the new music video that came up, Bossed Up. You feel me? How is it like a rags to riches type song? Is it towards certain of somebody? Is it like motivation for the hood?
What motivation. Is it?
Motivation.
For the hood, motivation for everybody, really. Okay. And just people like who going through, you know, in situations that's, you feel me, boozy as fuck, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So I made that, like, nigga, like, you feel me, hella shit was going on when I made that too.
Okay.
And I just pretty much was just talking shit, like, I got to boss up now type shit, you know.
Okay.
That's
okay.
All that was about.
Now for your music in general, how is it like you're, when you're in the booth, are you trying to like go for a record, like a hit record, or are you just, you feel me, stating what you see in the hood, or you feel me, state what you're going through?
Nah, I don't never go through no, I don't aim to try to hit a hit record, but I write okay. Straight off how I feel.
Okay.
You feel me? It's all how I feel, bruh. Like that's, when I write music, it's all about how I feel, you feel me, what I'm going through.
Mm-hmm.
You mean real shit, something that I might not even be going through, something else might be going through, you feel me? And I'm just talking, because I've been through it before, you feel me? Shit like that. I just be trying to spit real shit, bro.
Real shit.
You know, I just be trying to keep it, you know, have substance in my music.
For sure.
So, yeah.
And who is the artist that you listen to growing up that make you think that way? Or who are, you feel me, who stars that you looked up to, don't even have the rappers that made you think that way?
Shit, when I was in high school, nigga, I was listening to hella Lil Wayne.
Okay.
Mostly Lil Wayne, bruh. If you go back listening to, like, if you go back and look, listen to some of my music, then, nigga, you would listen to that shit and be like, this nigga sounds like Lil Wayne.
Okay.
You feel me? And I was just, that's how you knew I was inspired by that nigga.
For sure.
Because he was gassing every verse.
Okay.
So you feel me? So that's what made me want to go hard every verse. But, you know, the more I did music, of course, I created my own style. I don't sound like that nigga no more,
yeah.
But yeah, for sure, Lil Wayne.
Yeah, that's somebody good to definitely look up to, you feel me?
Definitely.
And his profession, he's the top at his profession, you feel me? So why wouldn't you?
Right.
Rob Marley, so where that came from, the Marley, you know, obviously you hear Marley, you think of the, you feel me, the big blower, you feel me? Big tree smoker.
Definitely smoking heavy, but shit. I used to go by Rob the Goon, right, in high school. And I was trying to, like, I was tired of going by that because people probably thinking, like, oh, Rob the Goon, oh, he a gangster, we finna see what, feel me, that type of shit. So I'm like, I'm not really trying to, you feel me, I'm not trying to put that, I'm not trying to, like, you feel me, come off like that. So I'm like, I changed my name. And everybody always already telling me, you like Bob Marley. Everybody I go, niggas are telling me, you like Bob Marley, you feel me? And I'm like, my name is Rob, like, you feel me?
Okay.
And then, you feel me, eventually I just was like, I was thinking a hella different shit. First I was like, Rob Marley, just hella different shit, bro. And I was like, fuck it, I'm Rob Marley, you feel me? And I put that shit on social media, and then I was like, trying to see what people thought about it.
Mm-hmm.
And niggas was fucking with the Rob Marley, so I just kept it, you feel me? My name really Rob, you feel me? So, yeah, that's how I did it, bro. And I actually met Damian Marley in person at the radio station in Sacramento.
Was love and when you met him?
Yeah, it was, you know, it was like a meet and greet type of thing. Meet so I didn't get to really talk to him like that. But
okay.
Somebody had asked a question about people using like their names, like as a rap name or something like that, like what I'm doing, like a Rob Marley. And he pretty much said, for me, it's love and respect. Like, they don't take nothing like personal. Yeah. Like, they fuck with it, like, yeah. For me. So that's what made me like, oh yeah, I don't give a fuck. Man. If it's like that, it's good, then fuck it. I don't give a fuck what nobody thinks. I'm not trying to be like nobody, you feel me?
Facts.
But yeah, right, that's how I came up with it, bro.
I mean, it's catchy. Cause a lot of motherfuckers not catchy. They don't know where to start off as far as their names, you feel me?
Right, that Rob DeGoon was not original, bro.
It wasn't. But a lot of niggas be sitting outside like the Temptations trying to think of their rap name, so at least you got yours.
Right.
Okay, so what's some artists you've been fucking with in Sacramento as far as like you want to feature from or already have featured from?
Damn. As far as who I got features from already, mm-hmm. like my bros, most of the part, like my nigga Tay, mm-hmm. he go by SF Tater. Who the last song? Like, what the fuck? Bro, I haven't done no music with nobody, but like, oh, I got a feature with, I ain't even gonna say that. That's coming. Something coming. You feel me? But I got a lot of shit, bro. I haven't been doing no music with real, like with niggas that got a name, so to speak, in Sacramento.
Okay.
But
anybody from Sac that you wanna do music with that got a name?
Who's a real artist? Like nigga like Nate Curry. Like me a real artist type shit. Like I got a lot of respect for niggas like Lil Darion. You feel me? And niggas that's been, niggas like Trey Solid and niggas like Nosh, you feel me? Niggas that been doing it and you feel me?
Shit.
Niggas been making moves for a long time and really been.
You saying some me? Niggas. I
ain't Nosh Boogie. He an older nigga from Sacramento.
Let me add that on my Apple. I need
definitely,
to
definitely.
Expand my music on my Apple, you feel me? Start slapping with some niggas.
Who else?
Them on the interviews.
I fuck with Street Knowledge. He not from Sac though, but he go crazy than me. It's a lot of niggas, bro.
Yeah.
It's a lot of niggas, bro. I don't know, but trying to do music with niggas that's been doing it and that know what they doing and respect me for my music and how I'm coming.
Okay.
For the most part.
So, with music, do you think Sacramento has a sound or is more individual? Individuality with the music, like you know how the Bay. Well, most people think the Bay got a sound.
I think Sac music. If you ask somebody what Sac music is like, it's all hood shit. All street shit. Mm-hmm. You normally
mob shit.
For the most part, like you nigga, it's a lot of it's mostly street shit, mob shit, slide and turn and nut. That type of music.
Mm-hmm.
For the most part, it's not too many niggas like me.
Yeah.
You feel me, like. When I say like me, like a niggas that's trying to spit about something that's going on, shit that matters, you feel me? Real things, you feel me? And making it tight, like you feel me? I really don't know.
What's things that's going on in your neighborhood? Real things that you put in your music.
You said what?
What's real things that you put in your music that nobody rapping about?
Like you feel me? The shit that be going on with black people and you feel me? Police brutality, you feel me? Struggling. Not, you feel me, going through it with your baby mama. Shit that niggas can really hear my music like, damn, I really went through that, bro. Like, you feel me, niggas feel that shit like, damn, it's really touching them. Like, you feel me, like, niggas, I had niggas tell me like, damn, bro, that one bar when you was like, this and that and that, bro, that really, bro. Like, yeah. Bro, that shit crazy, like, you feel me, that touched me.
Do you feel that the shit you put in your music now get more of the respect you think you deserve, or you think they gonna appreciate it more when you?
Oh no, I think
not. No disrespect, but you know how they say.
Oh yeah, of course.
Do you think they hear what you saying in your music now, or are they gonna appreciate it more later on down the line?
I think the ones who hear it. You feel me? But niggas who ain't hearing my music, for sure.
Yeah.
Of course they're not hearing it, but yeah, that's some shit. Like if I were to die today, nigga, what? My music is gonna skyrocket. I can guarantee all my music. Niggas are gonna be like saying, bruh. No, that should be Manny, bro. I promise. Like, niggas gonna wanna know who I am. Like, damn, you should have made it. And, you feel me? And I, bro. Because I be really talking real shit, bro. It's just the right person. When the right person hear me, you feel me? That's why I don't be tripping, bro. You feel me? My time gonna come, bro. As long as I keep it real. I already love music, so I'm gonna do it regardless.
Yeah.
So it's like, You feel me? I don't, ain't no rest. You feel me? I'm gonna get there, bro. Yeah.
So tell them your at name so they can go check your shit out.
Rob Marley, R-O-B, 2 underscores, Marley. Mm-hmm. That's exactly how you feel me? Just exactly like how it sounds, just like that. Mm-hmm. On Twitter and Instagram. Okay. Yeah, follow me. I just dropped a video called Ballin', shot by my boy Pylit. And I dropped Boss Up like 2 weeks ago. And I dropped hella shit back to back. So go drop, you feel me? Go tune into that shit. All my nigga Pylit shot most of that shit. Yeah, bruh.
It's dope.
Subscribe to the YouTube channel. Rob Carter, you search Rob Carter or Rob Marley on YouTube, you're gonna find me. Sure. Subscribe to my YouTube, listen to that shit. You feel me?
What's the next step for Rob and his career going into 2020? And also, now you just had a child, so how does that affect your music going forward? You know what I'm saying? Like, if, does it affect your music having a seed? You feel me?
Definitely.
Like in which ways does it?
Definitely. Definitely, it does affect my music. I be talking about, like, it's more shit that's going on in my life.
Yeah.
Because of my son, you mm-hmm. feel me? So, of course, I be talking about that shit a lot, bro, you feel me?
Yeah.
It's a lot of negative shit that goes on, you feel me, behind the background, and you know?
Yeah.
And that shit, yeah, of course, I express myself through my music with that shit. And then, as far as 2020, I'm planning on trying to, like, look more professional with this shit, like,
sure.
Start getting my music on these outlets, streaming outlets, and you feel me? Take that step to see, so niggas can see, like, oh, he's not just, you feel me? Like, okay, so push it on iTunes, and that's what I'm trying to do, look more professional. And then that's pretty much it, try to get some shows. I haven't performed since I was 16, you feel me? So try to get some shows.
How you think that's gonna go when you perform? Or you think it's just gonna, like, ride in the bike?
I think, I'm more, it's like I said, so when I feel like when I perform, it's just gonna be like, it's gonna be more so like, not going crazy. Like, I'm trying to get the crowd to hear me. So, cause I'm speaking some real shit. Like, okay. I want, so that's how I'm gonna be more of a.
You want them to hear your lyrics?
I want them to hear me. So, they're gonna see my vibe. They're gonna feel my vibe. You feel me? I feel like it's not gonna be no problem once I get back to it. But
that's a talent though, that you don't want a big reaction. You know what I mean? Yeah. So, you know, some people that go up perform, they don't get no big reactions. They gonna start sweating like Keith.
Right.
You feel me? Real nervous. But you feel me? You worried right. about your content, what you speaking. So it's kind of like, you feel me? There's no way that you losing.
Right.
Performing.
No way.
You feel me? Rob is performing at Stack Session New Year.
Definitely will be.
Along with a bunch of other artists. You feel me? That's gonna be on this shit. What do you think about? How do you see other things besides rapping? Do you want to act? Do you want to, what you mean? Start cannabis? What you want to do?
Oh, for sure. I for sure want to act.
Okay, okay.
I for sure want to do some funny shit.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, I want to act. What else I want to do? I want to probably, you know, I want to get my own, I want to have my own clothes for sure. Mm. Act. But yeah, I don't know. I wanted to play sports and shit, you feel me? I don't really want to do hella nothing crazy.
Yeah.
Just want to, I act though, for sure. I act, do some funny shit with my nigga Pylit.
So I got a movie called Heavy in the Game, you feel me? I'm trying to get you and my nigga Mr. in it, you feel me?
It's
trying
good.
To get all artists in there and build it up. I'm basically trying to have it like Friday, you feel me? Like. You know what I mean? Nobody knew they got so many stars in that fucking movie, you feel me? You didn't even know Megan Good was gonna be Megan Good. She was at the fucking ice cream truck, you feel me? So mm-hmm. I'm trying to put all my niggas in. I wrote the script, it's amazing. I would say it's like a mix of Pursuit of Happiness and Players Club.
You already wrote the script?
Yeah, yeah, it's all good. It's like a mix of Pursuit of Happiness and Players Club, so. You know what I mean? Yeah, it's gonna be. A1, so we're gonna get it started. I appreciate you for stopping by the session.
Definitely, you know what I mean? I appreciate you for
Rob will be
bro.
Performing, you feel me? And matter of fact, we're gonna go right into that motherfucker right now. Here Rob with his performance at Stack Session New Year's, you feel me? New, improved, And you feel me? Ones who didn't make it here, you feel me? We love you. Ones who here with us, you feel me? Enjoy the motherfucking session.
Definitely, definitely. It's Rob Marley, Bull Gang. You know what I'm saying? Greedy Gang forever. Definitely.
John Dunning.
It's time to ball, nigga.
Any other day.
Hey, it's time to ball, nigga. It's time to ball, nigga. Hey, listen to me, though.
What you say, nigga?
Hey, hey,
hey,
hey, hey, it's time to ball, nigga. I remember being out to the first mill like hard, nigga. Third man on boss, nigga. This shit is like it's on cross, nigga. You should be one of us who can't hide when you fuck around with some boss, nigga. Boss, nigga. Boss, nigga. Hey. I'm on my way to the top, though. I ain't to the top. Hey. I ain't worried about no this shit don't stop. This shit don't.
Niggas out here tryna smoke me. I'm just living life, I've been ballin' like I'm Kobe. On my way up, so niggas actin' like they know me. You there for me now, when I was down, you should've told me. Ayy, I'm just tryna cop a rollie. I came from the ghetto, niggas ain't had nothing for me.
Feeling like young Kurt, I don't need a bitch. You hang with four broke niggas, you gon' be the fifth. And I can't tell on no nigga, I'ma plead the fifth. It's been nothing but a journey how I came up. Speaking on me, speak the real. If you ever bring my name up, shit. This nigga carrying a hammer, but he ain't tough cousin. He posting pictures on Instagram, but he ain't bust nothing. Fake bluffing, man, I swear it isn't tolerated. I'm never giving up, even when shit get complicated. And you can't steer me off my path, I've been concentrating. Got some shit I'm holding in, but I ain't constipated. Ayy, I just wanna rap until I'm compensated. I have no choice, bro. I gotta make it wordplay. Metaphors and flow with a combination. Plus I make real music, but that's another conversation. Niggas out here tryna smoke me. I'm just living life, I've been ballin' like I'm Kobe. On my way up, so niggas actin' like they...
Yeah, growing up in the South, this how I used to do, nigga. Two-piece, nigga, you feel me? Yeah. Welcome to the motherfucking session. My boy Rob just got off the motherfucking stage, tore it up. You know how we do. You feel me? Ain't no surprise. Subscribe right now. Tell your mammy and them. I told my boy he had to come back, hit a freestyle. You feel me? Play Ninja Turtles, get loose. You feel me? Welcome to the motherfucking session. My boy finna hit this freestyle. We in
it. My girl told me let me lay you because these streets hate a black man. Plus the system trying to keep us niggas trapped in. I don't work a job because my agent keep me tapped in. We ain't bringing crack in shit. We just trying to get it cracking. My nigga Rare got a nigga dabbing. I'm getting high, I ain't gonna lie. Got niggas laughing, the trap booming. Shit, I got packs in the kitchen cabinet. There's plenty of beautiful women out here, but my bitch the baddest, a black queen. They can't fuck with this melanin. This shit worth more than gold, that's the reason they selling it. These doctors giving shots, fucking with our development. So how can you blame me for feeling out of my element in the presence of white crackers? Bull Gang.
Session. Hear the logo, you feel me? See the logo. You know what I mean? You know we're doing big talking, big smoking. I got my cousin here from Oakland, East Oakland to be exact, you feel me? Mari Mack, you know what I mean? He's gonna be taking the stage here at Stack Session New Year's Eve, so I'm getting a little questions with him, chop it up. You know what I mean? He's gonna tell you a little bit about his music. I told you he's from Oakland, but he's gonna tell specifically where he's from Oakland and his community. You feel me? So let's get into that. All right, Mac, where you from? Specifically in Oakland. And let the session know about you.
Yeah, I'm from Oakland, East Oakland. 55th to be exact. You feel me?
So growing up in East Oakland, California, 55th, like, would you say that is like a description of your music? Like, as a rapper, do you rap about what you go through, what you see, what your neighbors tell you, your homies? What do you rap about?
I rap about everything, like what I've been through, what I've seen, what I witnessed, everything. And it's like, it really depends. My music depends on my mood. Cause like I might be in a good mood, like gonna do like a little party song or something, like a little twerk song or something.
Okay.
And then you feel me, I'll rap about some pain, or I'll rap about just like, you feel me, catting off or turned up or something, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Shit like that. So it's just like, it really depends on my mood.
So you saw if a motherfucker wanna know who you are,
mm-hmm.
they could download Barry Mac album
mm-hmm.
and know who you are. You that dope of an artist where you can, if they download your shit, they know who you are. You that type of artist. You rap about what you go through, your struggle, and all that shit.
They gonna know exactly who I am in all shapes and forms. You feel me? So,
like, I respect it. So, who paved the way for you for that? Like, who did you listen to growing up? You know what I mean? Who was your influences, hip-hop wise, or beyond hip-hop, you feel me? Moguls, that's an R.
To keep it a Benji, my mom, she used to rap, like, you feel me, a little freestyle. You
okay.
feel me? So I got a whole bunch of family that raps, so it's just like, you feel me, I'm trying to do this too.
Okay.
You feel me? So, you know, I got my big influences with my pops, you feel me? So, mm-hmm. it's like, you feel me, always said keep it real. Like, keep it 100 all the time.
For sure, for sure. And I know you just, you feel me, my condolences, my cousin, you feel me, your dad just passed away. You feel me? We all praying for you. But as far as your music with that,
mm-hmm.
how do you see yourself going into 2020? How do you see that affecting your music? Like, as far as, like, being an artist, because you're an artist. It's no different than you and a motherfucking painter, you feel me? Them white people going in there, looking at them whack-ass paintings for about $50 an hour. It's no different, you feel me? So you're an artist, so how do you see that influencing you, you feel me?
I just gotta go harder than I was.
Okay.
So it's like, you feel me? If I want this, I gotta work for it. You feel me? If I'm just sitting in the house, I ain't getting no money.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So you feel me? Right now, I'm working on like a little tape
mm-hmm.
about Big Baller Dreams.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, it's just, you feel me? As the name say, Big Baller Dream. What I had to do to get to this point, and what I'm gonna do after I get to where I want to be. You feel me?
Okay. The song we made, you feel me? The Mary J. Blige, you feel me? Mari Mac, Big Roy, featuring Mary J., you feel me? If you don't like it, your mama will, because, you feel me? Hey, mama slap Mary J. Blige. The verse, tell me about the verse. Tell me about what you were thinking, what mindset you were in. And this is a pretty hard verse, and it sounds like you're just not rapping about some random shit.
Yeah. So it's just like, like I said before, it's just I was trying to like mix everything in. I had different emotions about it.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way the beat set up, it's like it's slow, but it's like it's not too slow. So it's like you gotta flow with it, you gotta play with it a little bit. So that's basically what I did. I played with it, I put different emotions into it, and came out with it.
Dope. Okay. It's crazy because as an artist being myself and stating what I'm going through, my issues and stuff like that, I know that right now you probably hurting, you feel me, because you took an extreme loss, but I know as an artist right now, because of that, you probably like in your prime right now.
Mm-hmm.
So like musically, like what kind of songs are you thinking about making? Like what's your most hottest song for 2020 that is actually gonna speak to people?
So actually speak to people, I say it had to be my intro, a Big Baller Dream.
Big Baller Dream.
You gonna feel that. You gonna feel that pain.
Okay. For sure. Your favorite artist right now?
Right now, I don't even know. I'm gonna say I'm still fucking with Meek Mills.
Meek.
Yeah.
Man, I think when they hear that, or hear this interview, they gonna see a lot of similarities. You feel me? You from the Bay, so you got your own method, your own rap like him. You feel me? But I think they gonna see a lot of similar methods. As far as this interview, you feel me? We gonna wrap this thing up. I wanna enjoy you for coming to the session, you feel me?
Appreciate it.
My cousin Mari Mac is about to hit the stage. Matter of fact, he opened it with me, you feel me? We doing that
Big Roy, Mari Mac featuring Mary J. If you don't like it, your mama gonna like it. You feel me? So I want to thank y'all and welcome to the motherfucking session.
Certified penny dropper, can't stop her. Watch it, cause I'm out, she gon' pop it. She gon' pop the pussy, she gon' pop it. She gon' pop the pussy. Oh, I'm by the bag, baby. Show me how you workin', huh? Might throw some money if I like the way you twerkin', huh? Now show me some, I take you home tonight. Face down, ass up, it's going down tonight. Oh, pussy pop it. No, baby, don't stop it after you top me. Got a blast like a rocket. Now drop it, drop it, drop it. Not to the clap, but baby, drop it to the Mac. I don't know what you're doing, but you know I like that. She throw it back, she throw it back. I want friend to break it back, like, goddamn.
Oh, yeah, yeah, fine rapper on me quick as hell. You need a toilet paper. Alright, so, I know y'all just seen the performance. You seen my cousin Mari Mac do his motherfucking thing, you feel me? I told him to come in here, you feel me? Play this Nintendo Switch, get whooped right now. Damn, I'm in second, I'm in first now. So get whooped right now and get loose, you feel me? And come hit this freestyle for me. You feel me? Let the session know his talent, so. I'm gonna continue whooping his ass. Why are you gonna whoop my ass? Why is it? So, Mari, get into it.
Alright, let me see. Hold up. Bring them poles out. You're like in Reapers by the way, you snatching shows out. I'm from 55th, but I ain't really into politics. But I'm popping shit. If you disrespect my politics, I'm tripping, nigga. I call him Mac and I ain't pimping, nigga. I take your bitch and give her back. Merry Christmas, nigga. No toe touch, your body bag, just in popping shit. You feel me?
Way to the top, though. Way to the top. Hey. I ain't worried about no one. This shit don't stop. This shit don't.
Niggas out here tryna smoke me. I'm just living life. I've been ballin' like I'm Kobe. On my way up, so niggas actin' like they know me. You there for me now? When I was down, you should've told me. Hey, I'm just tryna cop a rollie. I came from the ghetto, niggas ain't had nothing for me.
Certified penny dropper, can't stop her. Watch it, put on my, she gon' pop it. She gon' pop it, but she gon' pop it. She gon' pop it, pussy. Pussy pop up, certified penny dropper, can't stop her. Watch it, cause I might, she gon' pop it. She gon' pop the pussy, she gon' pop it. She gon' pop the pussy. Oh, I'm by the bag, baby. Show me how you workin', huh? Might throw some money if I like the way you twerkin', huh? Now show me some, I take you home tonight. Face down, ass up, it's going down tonight.
Bitch, cause I'm a real pig. Shit, everything on a bitch, I'm tryna get dope. Pippin' hoes at night, tryna get them up. Whip dope, sometimes it gets slow. But ain't nothing cause the pimp still ten toes. Switch up on a bitch, how I switch clothes. Call me Pimp Rob, living it by the pimp code. You a squad, know you eating it right. If I don't dog a bitch, I ain't really tripping.
They call me payroll, man. I'm one of the youngest niggas doing this shit right now. You feel me? Niggas better catch up.
Let me introduce myself. They call me K-Roll, one of the best pimps in the city. I stack hundreds, suck big 50s and spend 20s, get with me. I send bad bitches that's real pretty. Even got a couple strippers that shake your ass and titties. I rap a lot. Not to mention, I like to stack a lot.
I got a couple bitches that's twins, but they don't act like I'm acting right. Hoes equal, so they don't have to fight. You can't get too much of time unless the stack is right. I'm on now. Hella bitches calling my phone now. My ice right, I got my life right. I'm feeling grown now. I'm gone now.
A nigga came to me, cause his pussy got him stuck. Told him I don't want no baby, so he put it in my bag. Keep a couple different niggas, cause I like to figure up. And they all get to the money, so they eating me a cut. I make them all they got.
Niggas, I swear to you, make a nigga fall in love.
The only time you probably see me when I be on the track. Me and my bitches, we be happy when we leaving the track. While my hoes up on the plate, I probably be in the trap. I gotta get it, baby. I'm a jack of all trades, from tearing the blades down to trapping in hallways, always, baby. I'm just happy that y'all came. Yo, last nigga player, I'm winning the ball game, all game, baby. I ain't picky at all, babe. I'm pimping bitches that's thick and bitches with small frames. That bottom bitch shit get old, cause y'all change. Jealous tendency, hoes be going through y'all things. I got a white bitch and I call her my slave. She call me your majesty and do all that I say. I only fuck with bonafide hoes that like cake. So baby, stop what you're doing and come jump onto my train. You know my name, they call me payroll, fair game. I pimp hoes and wear chain, man, it's getting in gang, bitch. I lane switch and never be up on that lame shit. I take trips, you never see me on the same strip. Lil' Ant, Lil' Tay, Lil' Slug, that's that gang shit. We all get it in, probably pimping on your main bitch. It's that gang shit, baby, this that gang shit. Every city I go, they screaming like I'm famous. I know you hoes get the picture, man, you can paint it. Payroll, good decision, tell me if you wanna make it, baby.
Don't stress me, please, man. Touch me, tease me, bless me. Damn, little baby, too sexy. Had to fire her cause she was always trying to sex me. Hey, and you really can't expect me. I love pussy, but mama, I gotta get cheese. So run your bands up and address me. Cause I've been balling hard like I'm trying to win the SB, bitch. I don't even try, but I turn heads. Your legacy was ruined when you turned feds. Paid the bills, beat the fan, we don't burn bread. Never waste a bullet on a dummy, he can't learn it. So quit with all that extra shit. You might have had the better fit, but I had the better bitch. So go ahead, I ain't worried about your bullshit. 20 pounds, a few, 8 balls, and a pull stick. I show mad love, they still hate on me. That's why I stay state to state with the plates on me. Hey, only concern is them blue strips. 20 pounds, a few, 8 balls, and a pull stick. Hey, yeah, it's on me.
So don't test me, test me. Hey, more money, more problems, little bitch. So don't stress me, stress me. Yeah, it's on me. So don't test me, test me. Hey, more money, more problems, little bitch. So don't stress me, stress me. Hey, yeah, it's on me. So don't test me, test me. Hey, more money, more problems, little bitch. So don't stress me, stress me.
I'm just trying to fill my life with the best me. You buying pussy when you should be investing. It's so depressing when I see you flexing. I stay real, what the fuck I got to worry about? More than enough food for my kid's mouth. New fits, new kicks for the whole house. Niggas looking for some game, but I'm sold out. Yeah, it's on me. So don't test me, test me. Hey, more money, more problems, so
bitch. So don't stress me, stress me. Yeah, it's on me. So don't test me, test me. Hey, more money, more problems, little bitch. So don't stress me, stress me. Hey, yeah, it's on me. So don't test me, test me. Hey, more money, more problems, little bitch. So don't stress me, stress me.
Fuck a job, nigga, start your own business. Hire a family just to work so they avoidin' prison. I learned the game in the Bay, I just had to listen. Hustlin' every damn day cause they up in interest. Fuck a OG, you can make your own moves. Half of them niggas can't survive what you gone through. They say my father was a hustler, yeah, his son too. And I'm committed to the South, so what you gon' do? Can't wait to see us flex off them stack sessions, getting in and ATM checks. I remember them days when we was broken in debt. Niggas hungry, but they treat us like we nothing but less. If you ain't standing for your people, I ain't trying to hear it. And my city pull you over just by your appearance. If you ain't standing for your people, I ain't trying to hear it. In my city pull you over just by your appearance. I had to go to Vegas, hit them with the interference.
Five, six, seven, six, tell that the East Bay was his home. More mail than the rest of the pushers, cause he got a Tech 9 in the bushes. And that's how his game was handled. First name Jack, last name Daniels. Had two boys named E and Jack. E had the 9 and Jake the AK. Clocked on a street called Hennessy. Robbers with another brother named O.E. E had a freak and her name was Jen. Had a brother named Juice doing time in the pen. You couldn't tell that Jen was a freak though. Knocking boots with the dope dealer Cisco. E and Jack knew tonight they'd come. With two fat boys named Bacardi and Run. They capped Jack's freak and the sight was scary. She was all bloody and her name was Mary. Officer Martini wiped up the